This is the Minis Forum Neptune Series MPB7. It's powered by an Intel Core i7 13th Gen 13700H. Now that does have 14 cores, 20 threads, a lot of performance for such a tiny little mini PC. And even though it's small, it's got a lot packed into it. So Wi-Fi 6E, we've got two 2.5 gigabit LAN ports, two USB 4.0s, can run four displays even. And to top it all off, there is even room somehow for a 2.5 inch drive within this Windows 11 Pro mini PC. So this is what you'll find in the box. A SATA 3 cable, so you plug that in if you want to install a 2.5 inch drive, HDMI cable, our power cable, screws for the 2.5 inch drive, VESA mounting bracket and screws, and then a 120 watt power supply. Now the design, we've got a metal frame that goes around the outside here. We've got a reset button here for the CMOS, power on, 3.5 millimeter with mic support, and these are two USB 3.1s. Gen 1 here, Type-C Gen 1, and we do have microphones too. Microphone there. And if I flip it around, you'll see the rest of the ports. So two USB 4 ports there at the back. So that is video out data and power delivery too, I believe. It does state that can support it, but we do have our power in with the barrel cable that I showed you before. So HDMI 2.1, two 2.5 gigabit LAN ports here. So you could use this as a router if you wanted to do so. And the other HDMI 2.1 too as well. So you can run four displays with this particular model here. These are USB 3 type A's, 3.1, sorry, Gen 2. So Gen 1's on the front, but two Gen 2's here. And a Kensington lock slot. So this is one of two of the vents here for the ventilation, for the cooling of it. So that's going to be hot air, it's going to be pushed out from there. And on the other side right here, as you can see. Now gaining access to the internals to upgrade it, very easy. So you just need to press down here on the lid and that does pop up and you can remove it. So they have gone with brand components. You can see our two DDR5 SODIMs right there. So Crucial RAM, two 8 gigabyte sticks here. So at least it's running in dual channel and 16 gigabytes of RAM. MediaTek here for our Wi-Fi 6E. They've been using that before. And take a look at the cooler that's on top of our PCIe 4.0 SSD. It's a tiny little fan right on there. And there is a thermal pad underneath this. You can see a bit of a cooler there to keep everything cool. So you can gain access to all of the stuff you need right there. And if you want to know where you put that 2.5 inch drive, if you were going to add one, well, that goes on the top of that lid that I just pulled off. So here's the space here and you screw it into place and then you plug that into the motherboard. So very easy to install the extra components or upgrade the RAM or SSD and the wireless card. This I really do like. Then the underside, you can just see there the large cooler, so it's sucking the cold air from underneath, and that's blowing it out those two sides, and we've got the two VESA mounting points and four rubber feet. Here we are in our BIOS, and it is pretty much locked down to us because the only real advanced settings that are of any use are these ones here. So restore AC power loss, so if you wanted to run this as a server, this is perfect for you, or you're going to use it on a switch or something. And then under power and performance, no undervolting settings, unfortunately, which really does help out a chipset like this one, the 13700H. But we do have power limits, which I will be keeping stock. Of course, I'm reviewing it exactly it is out of the box. And then you've got your boot order. That's it. So quite locked down for Minis Forum. I would like to see it completely unlocked. They used to do that. So we have Windows 11 Pro, and I'll just show you right here that the free available RAM is slightly under 6 gigabytes. That's normal. They dedicate a little bit to the Iris Xe graphics. So this model here, I've been having a few issues with stability wise, because this is about the fourth time I've tried to record this running benchmarks and things. I've had it reset on me. Well, not reset, just power off completely and not power back on. I don't know what is causing this. I am going to reach out to Minis Forum, of course, and explain to them the issue. But it seems like when I have the Thunderbolt, should I say USB 4 ports, using those with an external drive, this can happen when you push it under heavy load. So it seems to be like a power supply or power issue there with it. Now you see in the device manager that we do have our 13th gen here listed 20 times. So it's a very powerful chipset. This is the 13700H and it's got 14 cores and 20 threads. Yes, that's a lot. So that's why you see it listed here so many times.
So we've got a RZ608 that's from MediaTek, and that is our Wi-Fi 6E. The Wi-Fi performance, even though the signal strength has always been good for me, I have found it to be definitely lackluster, not too impressed with it. Haven't been getting amazing download speeds. Steam downloads seem to be slow, but that could be something to do with them. But just in general, it doesn't feel quite as good as the Intel counterparts. Here we have a Kingston drive, so I have, of course, benchmarked that with Crystal Diskmark, and you'll see the performance here. It's all right, but for PCIe 4.0, kind of expected a little more. Now, it is surpassing the previous generation, so that's the best part there, but only really the read speeds are surpassing that. So the performance, a little more on that. I have run my typical kind of benchmarks here. So this is Night Raid, which is a 3D Mark score here, just checking out the Iris Xe graphics. So it does have 96 executional units. So the graphics score for integrated graphics is quite good there. And Geekbench 5, for some reason, I could not run Geekbench 6. It would just crash, or it would just power itself off with those issues. It's happened about 3 times now in total. So that's a good score. That's very powerful. It shows you how potent this is. And Cinebench, yes, that I have also run. So you can see here that the multi-core score and the single, very, very good. Now, I do have a laptop that's got a slightly better version than this chipset. It's the 13900H. That gets 19,000 points. This is 16, so very good because of all of those cores. And that is excellent. That puts it somewhere near some of those old AMD Threadrippers. I can't remember the exact model, like the 1950 or X or something. Very similar to that. So great performance here for such a small little mini PC. My only concern is, of course, those issues that I am having with those just randomly powering off. So the memory here, it could be quicker. So this does support 5,600 megahertz, but we're only running 4,800, that crucial RAM. Iris Xe graphics does have, of course, native decoding, RVP9, HEVC. So this is a 60 frames per second 4K clip, and it's running well. Not a problem there. I'm just going to mute that. You can see no real lags at all. No issues with it. It is running at 60 frames per second. Step it up now to the Jellyfish file. This is 140 megabits per second, HEVC 10-bit. Same story here, although it might have just dropped a frame here or there at the beginning, but this again is very good. This performance I'm seeing out of this mini PC. Now streaming 4K, this is in YouTube with Chrome, and it's not using the VP9 codec, it's AV01 that it's stating that it's using here, but still excellent performance. Look at this, zero dropped frames out of almost 2000. There normally is one or two here or there, but no, this playback is absolutely perfect decoding this. Here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro with my test 4K edit. So this is running fine. We do have the Iris Xe graphics. I've got 16 gigabytes of RAM, which is relatively fast. And when I hit playback here, it seems good, the performance. It doesn't seem to drop any frames. Now, do bear in mind, like I say in my other mini PC reviews, that this is only a very minor edit. It's about 10 minutes long. There's no fancy transitions. And there is hardly any B-roll, anything like that. So it's a best case scenario. But what I will do is test out those export times now. And we'll see how long it's going to take. 1 minute of footage using the YouTube preset. And there we go. It is about to finish up. So as soon as that disappears. So that was approximately 28, 29 seconds. A little slower than I thought it would be. GTA 5 now, so I have it set to the normal settings. View distance is in the middle and pedestrian density. Looking good, very good. This is around and over 80 frames per second when I'm in the car. And I'll just get out now, just jump out and have a look at the frame rate again. Really solid performance here, over 70 frames per second. So great for gaming, just lighter titles that is. So older titles like this one, Counter-Strike, will run just fine. So when you look at the thermals, there's a bit of thermal headroom. They're not actually bad at all. 85 degrees is the top, and thermal throttling, yes, apparently it has triggered it, okay? But it's quite a low throttling point that they do have set here in Mini's forum. Now, is this what is causing it to just completely power off? I don't know whether it is, but you can see that the CPU has pulled up to 95 watts, and I've seen from the wall socket around about 120 as well. So I don't know whether it's a power supply issue. Perhaps it's just not getting enough wattage. The power supply is 120, maybe it's pulling 130 with the external drives that I had connected when I pushed it hard, and that's what caused it to power off completely. Not good that that is happening. Now, fan noise, you do hear it when you're not doing anything demanding, like right now, it's reasonably quiet, but what I'll do now is push it hard and you will hear the fan. It's not super loud, super annoying, but you will certainly hear it. Linux Manjaro, as you can see, I tried to run it here, but this is as far as it would go. It would just sit on this screen pretty much forever. So it jams up, locks up, fails to load.
So pleased with the performance. It decodes video absolutely flawlessly. The video encoding performance too was quite good, was no slouch. A little slower than expected, but you do have to remember that it does not have dedicated graphics. Speaking of which, the Iris Xe graphics with the 96 executional units did do really well, aided by the fact that we've got the 4.8 gigahertz RAM speeds with this, even though they aren't the fastest that this 13th gen does support. So games like GTA 5, as I showed you, really quite playable as long as you keep the settings at around about 1080p. The thermals were fine. The fan noise, yeah, it makes a little bit. Linux couldn't get it to run. That was Linux Manjaro that I briefly just showed you. And there's a lot really going for this mini PC. However, I have had the reliability issues here with just this thing completely powering off if I used the USB 4.0 ports for long periods of time. Eventually, when I pushed it hard, it would just cut out completely and it would power off, wouldn't even reboot. So it was not thermal related. It's definitely, to me, power related. So I think it's just simply pulling too much power, more than maybe the power supply can handle. So it cuts out, powers right off. So that's a bit of a problem there. If you intend to use all of the ports, load them up with external hard drives as I did, well, you could run into that issue. Now, I've asked Minis Forum about this problem. Hopefully there's gonna be a solution. I'll let you know in the comments of this video. I will pin that what they do come back to me with. So thanks a lot for watching my review here of the MPB7 13th Gen Windows 11 Pro Mini PC from Minis Forum.